I've seen so many, too many same videos about American Home Shield and their predatory practices, and this is just my situation. So I purchased my home in 2017. Okay, single mom, two kids, no man in the house, and my realtor suggested American Home Shield for my home warranty, and I paid the $500 to get the policy started, and then I made my monthly payments around 2019, June of 2019, and I'm down here in Florida, by the way. My air conditioning unit stopped pumping out cold air. I contacted American Home Shield. They sent out a local vendor. Now, this was my first time running into this type of issue since I purchased my home. Just to give you some background, it looks like this is the original HVAC system that was installed when the house was built. The house was built in 2004. So, around 2019, it's about 15 years old at that point. But nonetheless, they sent a contractor out here. The contractor basically looked around, determined that I was low on refrigerant, told me that American Home Shield only covers the first $10, and then I was responsible for the refrigerant. Now, I had no idea about, how AC systems work or anything like that to even be suspicious at that point. Like I said, I was a relatively new homeowner and I had only been in my house at that point for not even a full 2 years. So it was like, okay, I guess that's right. So I paid the service fee and I paid the costs for the refrigerant to be added. And I thought that was the end of it. The following summer, in August of 2020, again, I had the same issue where my AC unit stopped pumping cold air. And I once again called American Home Shield. They sent out this same contractor. This time, the contractor came and he said, well, it's warm in here because it's hot outside. Now, I'm no genius at this point, and I'm not well versed in how AC work, how they work or anything, but that sounded stupid to me. It was like, okay, no, the whole purpose of the air conditioner is to make it to where it's not as hot in here as it is outside. Like, and so at that point, things started to, little red flags started popping up in my head. Like, this isn't right. And he was perfectly content with leaving and having done absolutely nothing except for check the filters, which all were fine. And I basically said, look, I'm not going to pay this service fee if you leave here and you haven't done anything. And only at that point did he actually go outside and check some levels and determine once again that my refrigerant levels were low. And so I'm like, okay. And then he's like, okay, so I know the drill. Okay, American Home Shield is going to cover the first $10 of the refrigerant. I have to be responsible for the remainder. And so once again, I paid that. So come March of 2021, just this past month, we're coming up off of the winter months. So now the AC system is being cranked up after being down for the winter, and it's not blowing cold air. At this point, I started to do my research and figure out, is the air conditioning, is it supposed to need refrigerant like every few months, or how does this work? And it was only then that I realized that you shouldn't ever have to put it in there unless there's a leak. And so now I'm like angry, okay, because now I'm starting to do my research. I contacted the contractor to try to get the work orders to see so that I could have proof that they didn't fix anything, that the only thing that they did was put a Band-Aid on it and ensure that I was going to have to call them again in the future to come back out, because they knew that there had to be a leak somewhere if they were there twice in a year, you know. So I contacted American Home Shield and brought it to their attention, and they basically were like, well, we can send another contractor out there, but it's going to cost you another fee, and then you're going to have to be responsible for paying for the refrigerant again. And I said, well, why would I do that? Why would I have to pay for that if it's clear that whatever the problem is was the problem when I first called you and you guys never fixed it? And so they basically, I had to speak to different people every day. Every day I had to call them and basically harass them, because I would always be told that someone was going to get back with me. Someone was going to call me back. Nobody would ever call me back. I requested supervisors to call me. No one's ever called me, never followed up. I haven't spoken to anyone who seems like they are native to this country, which makes it difficult for you to communicate. And I think that this is done on purpose. I've been placed on hold for like 30, 40 minutes, and then someone just would hang up. And so it got to a point where I just was like, okay, I'm going to have to seek legal action or something like that. And I started to read over my contract, and I came across something on American Home Shield's website in their own forum in regards to procedures when the contractor discovers that you're low on refrigerant. And the procedures state that they're supposed to detect where the leak is coming from and repair it, and or replace it if it's not repairable. And so once I had that information, I hired my own contractor to come and diagnose the unit. I said, I don't want you to fix anything. I just want you to tell me what the problem is. That way I know what it is, and American Home Shield can, you know, they can't really get out of it. So my contractor comes, he determines that there is a leak in the left side of the evaporator coil. He showed me exactly where the leak was, and it was really far back in there. He said, this can't be repaired. You're going to have to just replace this unit. It's already, you know, old. It uses R22 refrigerant, and that's been, you know, phased out and everything. So he wrote me up his diagnosis and everything for me to provide. I contacted American Home Shield again, and this time I said, now I had my own contractor come out here and confirm that there is in fact a leak in this unit. And due to the fact that you failed to enforce your own protocol, and request proof that that leak had been detected and repaired, then I'm requesting that you send out a contractor, and I'm not going to pay for it, and have them confirm that there is in fact a leak, and to have them do what should have been done in June of 2019. So they sent out a contractor, and that contractor came out and he confirmed that there was a leak in the evaporator coil. Now, this contractor detected a whole different leak, okay? When I tried to tell him where the leak was that my contractor found, he didn't even want to entertain it. He just ultimately decided that this can be repaired. He said, oh, it can be repaired. I've never seen an evaporator coil that could not be repaired. And so basically that's what he went back and told American Home Shield. Oh, this could be repaired. The cost for the refrigerant, though, we need that before we can repair it. And that was, my portion would be $840. And I was like, why would I pay that? Because if you guys would have followed protocol on the very first call, then you would have detected the leak, repaired the leak, and I would have only paid out of pocket for refrigerant that one time. But because of your negligence, I had to pay an additional time for refrigerant, and now you're telling me to pay again. And I'm like, I'm not doing that. And so American Home Shield basically said that, look, well, we will give you an offer in lieu of, the repairs, and you can find your own contractor. They offer me $300. $300 is, I was like, what is this for? Like, who is this supposed to pay for? Like, I was like, first of all, your contractor is the one that's saying that it can be repaired. I said, my contractor said that it can't. So you think you're gonna give me $300 to take to somebody else so that they can tell me that it can't be repaired, and now I'm stuck with $300 and no repairs because nobody is going to touch that unit for that little amount of money. And so I declined their offer. I said, no, I'm not gonna accept that. The only thing that I'm willing to accept is you sending out a different contractor and getting a second opinion, and you pay for it. Or if you have so much faith in the contractor that you sent out here, then you go ahead and give them the money for the freon, let them repair it, and then we'll be done with this. And so they refused. They wouldn't do it. At that point, I reviewed my contract. I determined that they were in breach of contract, due to the fact that it clearly states that they are supposed to repair or replace, and they didn't repair the problem. They only added freon, and that is a clear sign that there is something else wrong, and they failed to diagnose that. The vendor that they, the contractor that they hired, mysteriously lost all the records from when they came out to my property. American Home Shield said that they don't have the records or any diagnosis in their system from when that original company came out to my property twice. Nothing in their system, no diagnosis whatsoever. So that was really convenient on their part because now they have no way of saying, well, yes, they did detect a leak, or no, they didn't detect the leak, or whatever. So I started reading over my contract to see what my options were. Noticed that they have an arbitration clause in the contract, basically saying that you have to agree to contact them and try to work it out with them and settle, as opposed to going to court or anything like that. Because at this point I was like, okay, I'm gonna have to sue these people. But unfortunately, I have to go through these this route first. I have to send them a demand letter and try to settle with them. And I don't even understand, 'cause I'm like, if I send a demand letter, I'm gonna demand they replace the unit. And that's what I'm gonna be seeking in damages. Why wouldn't you just pay the $840 to the contractor if you thought that it could be replaced? And the answer to that is they know that it can't. I mean, they know that it can't be repaired. They know it. And so they don't want to give $840 to the contractor for freon that they know is just going to leak out because they have no incentive to do those repairs correctly. They're not getting enough money to even care about that. So they don't want to just throw $840 away to the contractor, but they don't want to replace it either. Because apparently, I've never seen a situation or heard of a situation where American Home Shield actually did replace an AC unit. So everyone that I know and everything that I've seen, most of the complaints center around the AC unit and how these people refuse to replace the AC unit, even if they know that the damages or whatever, they're not repairable, they refuse. And so it's predatory practices that they are supporting through these contractors, because they know that these contractors are just coming out here and doing the bare minimum, and they're fully supporting it. They're well aware of it. And I'm just like, at this point, I'm gonna do whatever I can to fight it, because I don't agree with it. And if anybody else has any advice for fighting this, please let me know, because I think that this is horrific, what American Home Shield is doing to these customers who are faithfully paying their premiums and their monthly fees and their service fees and everything like that. And then as soon as something goes wrong, they do everything in their power to try to avoid repairing anything. And I'm just to a point like, you'd be better off just taking the money that you would normally pay to them, putting it in a separate account every month, and then just, you know, keeping it there in case something goes wrong. Because quite frankly, after this experience, I don't think that I want another home warranty company. But that's just me. So